Hello everyone, Kiwi here. I want to give you my top 5 tips on how you can improve your pixel art today. These tips are easy to implement, and by the end of this video, you should see immediate improvement in your pixel art. So let's get into it. My first tip for you is to start off with a smaller canvas size. If you don't like the really bitsy look of 8x8 pixel art, then I recommend starting with 16x16 or 24x24 pixels for your characters. Whatever size you decide to use, just make sure that your background is in scale with your characters. I also recommend that you scale up your pixel art so it's high resolution and not tiny on your screen. Tip number 2, colors are everything. I went to school for art therapy, which is basically a combination of clinical psychology and art. And you may be asking, Kiwi, what does this have to do with pixel art? But stick with me because I'm getting there. So art can be used as a tool to express how one is feeling, but it can also be used to evoke feelings from other people. For example, blue typically represents relaxation or sadness, yellow represents happiness, and green represents security. Color can have a huge psychological effect on people, so it makes sense that it's really important when it comes to art or games. Unless you're an expert on color theory, it's hard for most of us to create colors that look good together and evoke the kind of response that we're looking for. My advice to you is to use a website like LowSpec or something else that has some pre-made palettes that already have some awesome colors. Tip number 3 is consistency with style and shading. This one is also so important. If you have some things outlined but not everything, and you're using some bright colors and some dull colors, it can be really easy for your project to look amateur quickly. For this reason, I recommend sticking with a style that's easy to replicate, such as a basic outline style with simple shading. Tip number 4 is to avoid corners in your outlines. This one is really just personal preference, but I feel like corners on your outline makes the outline look really thick and it can make your artwork look bulky. Some people like the look of corners in an outline, and if you fall into that category, then you can just ignore this tip and that's perfectly fine for you to do. I personally feel like it works much better on bigger pixel art because the outline is smaller in proportion. But when we're starting out with smaller pixel art, I like to leave off the corners in my outlines because I feel like it creates a smoother line. My 5th and final tip for you is to make copies as you work. If there is something you want to change on the character or the item or whatever that you're working on, make a copy of it and change it on the copy. It's really easy to just start making changes and then eventually you think you liked what you had originally better, but you didn't save a copy of it and you don't remember what you did. It can save you a lot of heartache to make copies as you go. Especially if you're using a software that has layers, I definitely recommend utilizing those layers to keep all of your artwork separate, and you can always use a layer to hide old versions of your artwork that you just don't want to look at all the time, and it keeps your workspace cleaner. Alright, so those are my top 5 tips for you guys today. If you've heard a pixel art tip that's helped you out that was not in this video, please comment it down below because I'd love to hear what's helping you guys. Also, if you have any requests or suggestions for future videos, please comment those down below too. My whole goal for this channel is to create tutorials that help you out, so let me know what you're struggling with. In the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun making it, and I can't wait to see you in the next one. Bye!